What you're about to see is one of the most infamous unsolved Easter eggs in Zombies history, finally solved after over 4 years. That is without question the most impossible Easter egg I have ever seen in Call of Duty Zombies. The steps involved are beyond impossible, and I think this Easter egg will go down as the most impossible thing that we will ever see Treyarch put in a zombie game. Like, my brain can't compute how ridiculous these steps are. And now that I've mentally prepared you, this Easter egg is on Dead of the Night. This isn't a silly little Easter egg with a cipher message. This has a full-on reward with 6 perks, Minculus grenades given to you, and even a new jump scare. It's all tied to the Vase Easter egg, which players discovered when the map came out over 4 years ago. Now, for context, this Easter egg was not solved legitimately, and it never would have, and this wouldn't have been possible without the legend in the Zombies community known as Sirius, who reverse engineered the entire game code and released it publicly, allowing the entire community to scan through the code to try and find Easter egg steps to Easter eggs that hadn't been found before. And 1.5 years later, he solved the Dead of the Night Vase Easter egg. So with all that context, let's show you exactly how to do this Easter egg and why it is so impossible. Now, this Easter egg in itself is incredibly complex to explain, so if you follow the method that I'm showing you, this will guarantee it to work. But I'll be adding additional context along the way, but once you've picked up the Sentinel artifact, we can begin. Sentinel artifact unlocks the staircase that leads you into the main hall, and from there, there are 5 different doors that you can buy to open up the rest of the map, such as the forest door, the cellar, the dining room, and the library. Now, each of these main doors that you spend points on are actually tied to a specific vase in the main hall. So as you open up the map, you need to write down the order in which you open these rooms. And in each of these rooms, there's going to be a candle, as you see me looking here in the forest, and we'll talk about the candles in a later step. To make this as easy as possible and to follow what I do in the video, just open the map in the order I'm doing. Now, not only do you have to open up the map and write down the order of the doors, but there is another Easter egg step that you have to do in tandem with opening up the doors that requires you to also write down the order in which you come across things, as that is going to be crucial as well, which are record players. All around the map, there are hidden record players, and you're going to need to write down the order in which you discover them. The game is actively checking for players that physically walk up to and look at record players. So naturally, when you're opening up doors to the rest of the maps, you're going to come across these record players, and you're going to need to write them down. So we're going to start off with the forest door as the first door that we open. If you started on the left side of the spawn room, in order to get to the Sentinel artifact, you're going to be walking through a room called the music room, where there's going to be a record player, which you need to look at up close for a few seconds. So when you're doing this step, I highly recommend you have like your notes app open on your phone or a notepad to write this all down, and I'll have the notes physically on screen so you can follow along. The next door we're going to open is going to be the cellar, and then the third room we're going to open is the dining room. Now, once we go into the dining room and walk past the big dining table and the fireplace, there's going to be a record player tucked up here in the corner. So just walk up to it, look at it for a few seconds, and then write that down as well. From here, we're going to open the door directly in front of us to the greenhouse, and we're going to write that down. Then we're going to go back into the main hall and then open the adjacent door that will lead into the library. And on the bottom floor of the library near the back corner here, you'll see there is another record player that we're going to walk up to, look at it for a few seconds, and then write that down in our order as well. Once we've done that, we're going to go up the stairs and we're going to open the debris that will lead us into the cemetery, and we're going to write that down as our final door. So on screen is the order of doors that we open from first to last, but we need to get the last record players. Next record player we're going to go for is the West Gallery, which is the right side of the spawn straight down the stairs. Second to last record player is going to be in the master bedroom, just tucked away on this table in this corner. So again, go right up to it and look at it for a few seconds. And the final record player is tucked away inside of a side Easter egg, opens up a secret bookshelf on the east or west balcony. We're going to be interacting with both bookshelves, and we're looking for 2 books, which are going to be in the same position on both bookshelves in the east and west balcony. And we're looking for a specific order and symbols on each of these books. In the top left, I'm showing you the symbols and the order in which you interact with them. So you're going to look at both the east and west balcony and look at these books, and you're going to activate these books in the order of the symbols on them. As you see on this side, I find the symbol for the first activation and then the symbol for the second on both books on this side. So I activate both. I then run over to the opposite balcony and activate the 3rd and 4th symbols on those books. Once all 4 have been activated in the correct order, the bookshelf will reveal a secret room that will have the final record player. So we'll walk up to it, look at that, and our final record was found in the east balcony. Okay, so at this point, you're going to have 2 sets of orders written down. We can now begin with the actual vase Easter egg step, and each of the doors that we open links to a specific vase that is going to be hidden above in the main hall. There are six vases that are connected to the six doors, and we're going to need to shoot them in the order in which we open those doors. So since we open the forest door first, that vase is going to be above the north atrium bridge where you first spawn. Now, these vases need to be shot with a pack-a-punched trebuchet shotgun, as you need to land grenades in the middle of these pots for them to explode. Now, in the interest of time, Sirius has modded my starting pistol to shoot these grenades to help me show you guys this Easter egg. The vase won't explode unless the grenade lands directly inside of it. So we're going to do a little bit of no clipping here just to make sure we get it directly in. But that's the first vase destroyed, as that was linked to the first door we opened the forest. The next vase location was for the cellar, and the cellar vase can be found just to the side of the grand staircase here. So we'll get a grenade launcher shot directly in that one. We then open the dining room, which is going to be on a pillar above the dining room door. And as you see, there are two vases. We're going to be shooting the one which is lower between those two pillars. So we destroyed that one. And then the next door we opened was the greenhouse, and that's linked to this vase, which is just to the right and higher up. The next room we opened was the library, and the vase for the library is just above that door, again, on the lower position between those two pillars. And then finally, we opened the cemetery, and the vase for the cemetery is again really high up there. Once all the vases are destroyed, you're going to want to run to any of the doors you opened and look for the candle. I pointed out earlier, if the candle is no longer lit, then the step has been completed successfully. If the candles are still lit, you failed and you have to restart the game if you want to try again. But now you notice that all those candles are no longer lit, we need to go ahead and light each of those candles using Wraith Fire grenades. Now the candles have an order, and you would think they'd be linked to the order in which we open the doors, but for some reason, Treyarch wanted to make this as impossible as it could be. And so you actually have to light the candles in reverse order to the doors you open. So since the cemetery door was the last door we opened, that's the first candle, and the location for that is there on that bookshelf. We then opened the library second last, so this will be our second candle, which we can find in the west hallway. Then because we opened the greenhouse as third last, that will be the third candle we light, which you can find out on the terrace here. And again, you just throw a ray fire. Working our way backwards again, the door we opened before the greenhouse was the dining room, and the location of that candle is in the east hallway right here. Working our way further back still, the second door we opened was the cellar, so the cellar will be the second to last candle we'll light. And this is in a really difficult place to find. It's going to be tucked up all the way here on this barrel. And after one or two ray fire throws, you should land that. And then because the forest was the first door we opened, the forest will be the last candle we light, which you can find over here. Once you've lit this candle and the candle stays lit, that means you've completed this step correctly. If the candles go out, you failed and you have to restart this Easter egg in a brand new game. Okay, now we can move on to the next step. And remember, I got you to take down the order of the record players. But if you make your way in the bedroom hallway to the east stairway, you will now see a vinyl record would have spawned here, which was never here before. It will only spawn if you've completed all the prior steps correctly. With the record we've just picked up, we now need to interact with every record player we came across to play this record. But to make this Easter egg even more impossible, you're not activating them in the order we found them. You're going to activate them in reverse order, just like the candle step. So since the east balcony bookshelf was the last one we discovered, it's going to be the first one that we interact with. Now, when you interact with these record players, it's going to play a short snippet of the music Easter egg for Dead of the Night called Mystery. Now, I really like this feature of this Easter egg step, playing the snippet of the Easter egg song. It's really, really cool. But once the record has stopped, we're now going to move on to the next location. So the master bedroom we've done second to last, so that's going to be the second record player. Then we're going to go to the west gallery, as that was the third last. Then we're going to interact with the one in the library, as that was our third one. Then we're going to interact with the record player in the dining room, as that was our second. And then finally, we'll interact with the music room as the last one, as that was the first one we came across. Once that's finished playing, you have completed that step correctly and can move on to the final step. And if you thought everything up till now wasn't that difficult, then this just takes it to a whole new level. If we make our way over to the main hall towards the forest door, right where my pistol is aiming, there is going to be an invisible ghost. The only way that you can tell its presence and position is by a sound. So you have to go up to it, and then this ghost is going to start moving. I'll stay silent for a few moments so you can hear the audio of the ghost. The But essentially, you need to be aiming towards this audio and it's going to fly around the entire map. And the only way you can track where this ghost is and where it might have gotten to if you've lost it, simply to look for the audio. This step has to be one of the cruelest steps I've ever seen in a Treyarch Zombies Easter egg, as the likelihood of you losing where this ghost is so incredibly high that you could fail this Easter egg at this point by not knowing where it is. But I'm going to fast forward this footage a little bit so you can see the exact path that the ghost follows. And the only reason why we know where this goes is because Sirius released a video showing this Easter egg, and he placed a floating model that takes the position of the ghost so he could actually see where it was going and follow it the entire time. But you'll hear this invisible ghost lady laugh, as well as hearing that just weird wispy sound effect of the ghost. And again, without his video, I would have had no idea the path that this ghost was going and knowing where exactly to look. Because again, if you're not looking at the ghost, then the ghost just isn't going to move. But as with the many visible ghosts that are on this map through the various Easter eggs and stuff to do with Pack-a-Punch, it will fly through walls and essentially take you on a massive tour all around the map. But it's when it's finished at the library and going towards the cellar that this Easter egg becomes 100 times more impossible. Because once you get down the stairs here towards the right side of the cellar, the ghost is going to be frozen in this position that I'm aiming at. And again, we only know this because of Sirius. But at this point, the ghost is going to be in a crouched position, and you as the player, which includes all players in the game, have to go prone and move forwards in order for this ghost to keep moving. And as you see, I'm actually getting stuck in places where the ghost is not moving because I'm not looking at it. You have to stay prone the entire time and keep crawling where you're seeing so the ghost moves whilst there are zombies spawning around you. And once you're in this position looking towards this corner, just keep crawling all the way to these barrels, and you're going to see the most unexpected thing ever. The ghost will go into the wall. There's going to be a new jump scare that's never been seen before in Dead of the Night. And once that jump scare has ended, you will be rewarded with six perks and the homunculus equipment. This has to be one of the greatest side Easter egg rewards we have ever seen in Call of Duty Zombies, giving you the closest thing to a perkaholic as well as the most useful equipment in the game. I'm so happy that after this Easter egg being unsolved for 4 years, the end reward is really, really good. But the steps involved to get that are without question the most impossible thing I've ever seen. Now that you've seen all of the steps play out, you can agree that this is without question the most impossible Easter egg ever in Zombies. There's complex Easter eggs, and then there is that. That is in a whole league of its own. And I'm honestly really puzzled at how Treyarch even thought that anyone would ever come across all of those steps in that order without failing once. It is absolutely crazy. But please let me know what you think about this Easter egg in the comments below. Is this the most impossible thing you've ever seen in Call of Duty Zombies? If it is, then drop this video a like rating and subscribe. Whilst you're at it, go over to Sirius's Twitter and YouTube link below and give him some incredible props for finding out this impossible Easter egg.